That's Stan the man.
Stan is a funny guy. Stan is a funny guy. I'm telling you right. People, what's going on? Tom Shields Live. I know I come on full of energy every Thursday night. It's a live program. It's the 21st of February. As I'm speaking, I've had a very long day. I'm raising the volume of my voice. I could feel pressure. I could feel pressure if a doctor is watching. Can he call in and please tell me, do I have blood? What is it, a blood pressure issue? What is going on? I'm hot. It's hot in this freaking studio tonight. I don't know why. What's going on, people? I'm telling you, we got some stuff to talk about. We got President Obama playing golf with Tiger Woods. Tiger Woods, who sleeps with prostitutes all over the United States, goes to Las Vegas, sleeps with 2 to 3 girls, cheats on his wife, one of the worst representatives of what a natural marriage is, if you know what I'm trying to express, and President Obama plays golf with him. President Obama initiated it and plays golf with him. I mean, come on. Really? Really? Like, do you really have to do that? Play golf with Tiger Woods while people are suffering in this country? I'm almost every time. What's up, Marshall? Marshall J. Every time I think about politics and what's happening in the White House, I get sick. I get sick to my stomach. I feel, right now, I'm not even lying. I feel a sense of vomit in my esophagus. I'm not being funny, nothing. I'm totally serious. I get emotional, I wanna cry. I'm very similar, I have a very similar mental issue, very similar to John Boehner. How John Boehner, he could cry, you know, cry at the drop of a hat if he thinks of something sad, he cries. Really? That's for people who are not well like me. Now, I'm not the Speaker of the House, so if I want to cry or vomit, I could do that. Yes, it is, Marshall J. What's up, babe? Oh, man, we're getting people in from the other networks now because the other network shut down. What's up, G? What's up, Sergeant? What does that say? Sergeant Pummel or something like that. What's going on, babe? I'm telling you, folks, we all have to see. The thing is this show, I try to get everybody to band together. It's a silly, I don't consider this a silly little show. I consider this a show of information. This is a wealth of information. I make it easy to understand because I'm not that bright. But the thing is I know right from wrong. I know what's going on in this country is so wrong. I know that the Democrats are ruining this country. They think, let me tell you something. First of all, do you ever know when President Obama comes out with an idea? He goes across the country like if he's still running for president. He campaigns his ideas in different states because he loves public speaking. He doesn't care about the economy, folks. He doesn't care about you. He cares about his popularity. That's all he is concerned with. Because unfortunately, when you are a popular person and you're likable, whether you're doing a good job or not, people start to like you. People across the world start to like you because you're popular. Did you ever notice when you went to high school, there was always this one kid who was a complete loser, but he was popular. He was like a popular kid, you know, even though you probably know the person now and he's like working at a fast food joint or something, you know, he's probably raking leaves for a living. He was a loser. But in high school, he was popular and everybody looked up to him. Not that he was doing a good job in life, not that he was actually going to become successful. He was just popular. But he turned out to be a nobody. Hello? Hello? Here we have a president of the United States who does not do his job well. He does not help the American people. He does not, he's not helping the economy. He's not lowering the deficit, but he's popular. So you know what's going to happen about 5, 7, 10 years from now? People are going to look back once a Republican gets into office and cures this problem that we're having in this country. They're going to look at President Obama and say, oh my God, how could he have done such a thing? How could, but people say, you know why? Because he was popular. And the people that collect welfare and government assistance, they love this popular guy because he gives you things. He gives you things off the backs of hard-working Americans. Those people on welfare and government assistance, you ought to be ashamed of yourself. The people that deserve government, the people that deserve disability, that are actually disabled where they need disability insurance. I have a little gas problem right now. Hold on, folks. You know, those people, fine. There are people in this country that need financial help because they're disabled in one form or another. I am talking about people who take advantage of disability, take advantage of food stamps and state assistance. Those are the people that I'm talking about when I say that you want something for nothing. You hear me talk about it every week. Obama's going to give you this. Obama, yeah, I talk about Obama. This is a politically based show. You know why? Because you know what I did today? Let me tell you what I did today. And I'm sure a lot of people are in the same boat. I got up at 5 o'clock this morning. I was in the shower at 5:30. Well, Tom, what'd you do from 5 to 5:30? None of your business. None of your business what I did for that half hour. But nevertheless, I was in the shower at 5:30, okay? I was out the door by 6 o'clock. I was at Home Depot at 6:15. And my day has not ended yet. It is 9:10 on the East Coast, and I am still going. I am still doing the show. I got out of my garage at 7:30 tonight, drove over, got food to go, came here, and I'm doing the show. That's what my day consists of, President Obama, because I have to put food on the table. I have to pay my bills. I'm not playing golf with Tiger Woods while everybody else is suffering. I'm not playing golf with a guy who cheated on his wife with prostitutes. Can I say it enough? Tiger Woods cheated on his wife with prostitutes. So President Obama gets on the phone and calls him. Do you think he cares about what we think? He is out for a good time. He is President of the United States, and by golly, he is a rock star. And that's how he looks at it. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. What is wrong with my applause? It's stuck. I got to... There it is. A little late. Better late than never. You know what I'm talking about? And we thank you for that, Tom. Thank you, Minnesota. Oh, man, I'm telling you. It's tough. It's a tough world out there. And I want, when people are watching the program, I know I act a little crazy and, oh, Tom, how can we take? Believe me, folks, it's sincere. I am very passionate about this country. I might act a little odd on this program from time to time, but I have to entertain myself to get through the 60 minutes. Because if I think about all the horror in the world, all the wrong that's going on in government, I'll go out of my freaking mind. So I do things to try to make, you know, I try to make myself laugh. Hopefully you're enjoying what's going on, but I want to express, I want to relay information. Tom, you're stuttering. Tom, what kind of show is this? Folks, you try to do a live show and be passionate about this country. You try to do a live show and be passionate about being an American, a proud American, someone who's proud of this country, someone who could wake up in the morning and say, wow, this country is prosperous. This, I can go out and look for a job. Let me, folks, listen to me for a second, all right? People, listen, I was in Subway today having a sandwich, And it was so sad. I watched I would have to guess a gentleman about 47 years old walked into Subway. I was eating my sandwich and he went up and he said, "Is there a manager in?" And the girl came up, the girl must have been like 21 years old. "I'm the manager," and the guy said, "Hi, I'd like to apply for a job. I'm wondering if you need any help." I felt so bad. I had to look down and eat my chocolate chip cookie because I could not believe what I heard. It was so, really, folks, it was, let's get serious for a minute. It was sad. And 3 days before that, I was getting some pizza to go. I went to go pick it up. I did not have it delivered. I went to go pick it up, and there was a girl in there. She must have been about 38, 39 years old. Tired looking, you know, not a bad looking girl. No, let's not get off the topic. The thing is she, she was discussing with one of the other delivery pizza, well, I don't know what you call them, the delivery pizza people, and saying how she's so exhausted, but she has to work 3 jobs to make ends meet. And delivering pizza late at night to make ends meet is what she has to do because she's a single mom. Oh my God. Does the president and politicians see this every day? Do they see what's going on? I got the vomit here and I'm almost gonna cry. Oh, come on. Do they don't even see what, no, go play golf with Tiger Woods, President Obama. Why, the pizza delivery girl, she's only on this earth, she's on this merry-go-round one time. She's a human being. A living human being, an American citizen. She doesn't have another life to live when this one is over. This is the one she's got. And because you're out playing golf with Tiger Woods, you son of a... This girl has to deliver pizza late at night to make ends meet. 3 jobs she has to work. What are you doing in the White House to create a job? What are you doing to create a job? Let's think about it. You create one job. That person, what does he do? He's a wage earner, okay? He's paying taxes to the government. Hello, that lowers the deficit. Not only that, he's gonna have extra money to spend at a local store, which indirectly, when you purchase something, you pay sales tax. So your local town and government collects the sales tax. And they prosper. So the government's prospering off of this individual working. The state and local governments are prospering because this person is going out and purchasing items. The stores that he frequents are becoming busier because people are coming in and spending money, people that are getting jobs are coming in and spending money, so the store has to take on more employees to handle the rush. So do you see people in the White House? All you have to do is worry about creating jobs. It will take care of the deficit in this country. It will take care of the deficit in the states and the local towns. Oh my God, is it really that difficult? We get on TV and the Democrats talk about, well, the way to lower the deficit is to raise taxes on the wealthy. Shut up! Just, oh my God, no! You have to create a job. Lower taxes, people will create jobs, they will find, give people an incentive to create a job. Make a business owner say, yeah, wow, is this what the government's gonna do for me if I hire an employee? Is the government that stupid or are they just ignorant? Oh my God, I am so passionate about this. Just create a job. If there's there are 20 million small businesses in this country. I'm not talking about small businesses with 200 to 500 employees. I'm talking about small businesses with 10 to 20 employees, or perhaps even less than that. There are 20 million of those small businesses. If each business hired one employee, holy cow, do the math. There's 20 million jobs created. And those 20 million jobs are taxpayers. They pay, and the deficit will, and they'll go out and spend money, and then other places will have to create jobs because they can't handle the rush. And then the local towns and governments will have their sales tax coming in, and they'll be like, oh my God, there's so much money coming in. What are we gonna do? Let's create some more jobs. Let's create some shovel-ready jobs. Now they're creating jobs, the states, because they got so much money coming in. And now people, and it's becoming a frenzy. Oh my God, there are so many jobs being created. Do you see? That's all the government has to do is worry about job creation. What do we have? We had Joe Biden come to Connecticut today. Today's February 21st. He came to Connecticut to talk about the gun thing. Yeah, I know that. We gotta start talking about creating jobs. It's all about popularity. You should have seen him when he came here and, hey, everybody, signing autographs. Hey, hey, it's a big pop. President Obama playing golf with Tiger Woods. Hey, Tiger Woods, we're both black. Let's play. You know, you cheated on your wife. I'm cheating on the government. I'm cheating the people in America out of their livelihood, and you cheated on your wife with prostitutes. So let's play golf together. Oh, boom, 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 boom. Oh my God. Can't get any, you know? Come on. Come on, really? People, come on. Can we all be passionate about our country? Can we just all be passionate? You know? I mean, what is it? It's winter now. You know, spring is coming. But we're going to have another snowstorm this weekend? You know, it's winter. Winter. I don't know if my friend got that, but indirectly I was saying hi to somebody. Don't bother with the relying on Obama. Start an under-the-table home-based business over the internet and stop giving your money away for politicians' vacations. Walker, let me tell you something. You have a very good point there. Why don't we boycott the government? No, we can't do that. But I understand where you're coming from, Walker. I understand. Let's, you know, there was a time, Walker, when the government wanted to shut down Craigslist because they were upset that people were buying and selling but not paying their fair share of taxes. It's all about taxes, isn't it? All you have to do, people in government, is create a job so that people don't have to go out and rebel against the government. Do you know gas has gone up 50 cents a gallon in 2 freaking weeks? But our stupid freaking president, and I'm gonna say it because I am very passionate about what's going on in this country. I'm very passionate about the problems that I deal with every day, and because I deal with them, I know everybody else is dealing with them. Do you understand why I'm raising the volume of my voice? But I try to keep some humor in this somehow, just keep my sanity. But the thing of 50 cents a gallon, you know why? Because Obama keeps coming out and saying, oh, we got to go with green energy. Green energy is the way of the future. Oil is the energy of the past. Let me tell you something. Let's use a little psychology for a minute, which, of course, people like President Obama, who's left-handed and can't golf for the life and wears shorts up to his freaking nipples, looks like a freaking idiot on the golf course. Those people have no common sense. He has no common sense. Can you think he could sit back and say, hey, let me just come out and say, most likely we're going to start drilling in America because gas prices are too high. You know what that's going to do? That's going to make the speculators go crazy, drop the price of oil so that they can convince us not to drill in the U.S. so they can keep that hold on us. but they will drop the prices. I'm telling you, that would happen. It will happen. It's not supply and demand. Right now, it's a little bit of supply and demand because of the regulations that the White House put on the oil and gas companies to create a cleaner fuel for the up-and-coming travel season. This is what President Obama does for the middle class. Do you people even know that he raised your taxes like 2 to 4%? Everybody's getting less in their paycheck now, so they're spending less. People at Walmart, did you hear about the emails going out on Walmart? The CEOs, the executives are saying, where are all the customers? We have such, our profit is, we don't even have close to what we had the profit last year. Where are all the customers? How come no one's spending any money? These are what the Walmart executives are saying. And if people aren't spending money at Walmart, what does that mean? When you raise taxes on people, they stop spending money. It's freaking common sense. You raise taxes on the wealthy, they stop hiring people. You raise taxes on the middle class, they stop spending. The whole country comes to a freaking economic freeze. Oh my God, are these people that stupid? I don't even have a Harvard degree. And I can figure this out. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, I can't even believe it. Hello? See, I gotta do that to be a little funny. Oh. They have nothing but excuses. But you teach the kids at the lowest level and keep them, and keep from K through 12, you have no excuses. Hence, the Obama raise in the minimum wage. That's another thing. Let's talk about the raise in minimum wage. There's a lot of ill-informed people. There's people who are just not politically informed. And when you're not politically informed, you can sit back and say, wow, raising the minimum wage is a great idea. People can earn more money and they'll spend more money. No, that's not what happens. I told you earlier, the majority of small businesses in this country hold 10 to 20 employees. They're having a tough time as it is with all the taxes they have to pay to the government for having these employees. But now, because they have maybe some kids that are working their way through college and they hired them on and paying a minimum wage, now the government wants to raise minimum wage to $9 an hour. So now this small business that has 10 to 20 employees, they can no longer afford to hire that extra person because it's going to cost too much. So that extra person will not be getting a job. Do you follow me, folks? Raising the minimum wage is not a smart idea. Duh. Oh, but Tom, the people are going to have more money. No, they're not. There's going to be less jobs created. And when there's less jobs created, there's less revenue for the government to lower the deficit. There's less revenue for your local and state political branches. And then there's less money for you to spend. It's just, oh my God. It's so, for him to, you know what it is? It's the popularity, it was the popular thing to say. It was the popular thing to say, to come out and say, let's raise the thing to $9 an hour. It was popular. He doesn't care about actually what takes place, if it happens or not. By him saying it, it made him more popular. That's what this guy is about, and people wake up. Wake up and realize it. Oh my God. Wake up and realize it. You're right. People who have full-time positions will be brought back to part-time positions. People making $16, $17 an hour will have their wages lowered to $15, $14 an hour so that they can pay the part-time workers the $9 an hour. So when they're hiring these college kids, you know, or the mother that wants the third job so she can take care of her son, but now the particular small business cannot take on that mom that wants to earn a little extra money to take care of her son. Why can't she get that job? Because the small business can no longer afford it, because $9 an hour is too much and they don't want to go bankrupt. They don't want to close their doors. So the five or six employees, because see, when a small business owner has to pay more wages, they have to pay more taxes to the government. See, when you're a business owner and you're paying an employee a wage, you're not just paying that wage. The employee has to pay taxes to the government, but unbeknownst to a lot of people, ill-informed people, the business owner has to match the taxes that the employee is paying. So not only does the business owner pay the employee, the business owner has an extra penalty of paying an extra tax for having that employee employed with them. You following me? Now you take it to a $9 an hour, that employee is paying more, the employer is paying more tax. So the employer can no longer afford to pay certain employees if the minimum wage goes up to $9 an hour. Follow me, folks. It's a stupid idea. It just makes him look popular. It has nothing to do with you, the American wage earner. Nothing to do. He's stupid. He has no common sense. Who are you talking about, Tom? Don't disrespect the president, Tom. If he's doing a lousy job, there's got to be someone that stands up and says something that's in the media. It may not be the most politically correct thing to say, Bill Maher. Who is the... I can't even stand watching Bill Maher. He is freaking stupid. He has no common sense. The things he talks about are freaking make me want to puke. Oh, Tom says the word. Tom is so harsh. Let's turn the channel, honey. Tom is too harsh. Oh, it's the half hour mark, folks. Should I play the PSA or should I keep on going? Because I'm on a roll and I don't want to stop yet. I mean, really, all people got to do that are watching the program is just type in a particular topic and I'll go off on it. And the thing is, I'm not just going off on it. I'm making perfect sense. I'm making perfect logical sense. There is no other, no, I am not wrong. I am one of, Tom, how could you always say you're right? Because I am, I'm sorry. I am sorry, but I am right. From the things I've said at the opening of this program have been 100% accurate. 100% factual. And by golly, common sense rules the world. Worrying about raising the frickin' minimum wage to $9 an hour. It's the popular thing to say. Talking about green energy. We're gonna have green energy, you know? Green energy is the way of the future. Wow, that's a popular thing to say, President Obama. But as soon as you say that, all the speculators and people in the oil companies realize, oh my God, if they're going towards green energy, let's get them, let's sock them as, let, if they're, let's get the oil prices up as high as we can so that the people are, let's get gas prices to $5 an hour. Because the United States, they're not going to drill in their own country. They have to rely on foreign oil. So let's raise the prices because they're not going to do a damn thing about it. That's what goes on in people's minds when the president comes out and publicly says that we're going to go towards green energy. Global warming, forget about oil. Oil's the energy of the past. You stupid. How could you say such a thing on a public forum? Oh my God. How freaking ignorant. How stupid. How, oh my God. I can't even, I got vomit right here. I can't even believe it. People, I'm saying this because we all need to band together and realize the right and wrong that's going on in this country. I can't even take a breath. I want to get this information out so fast. Oh. populate. That's what it was. He goes on campaigns. We're going to do green energy. All right, I'm going to go to North Carolina and talk about it. Then I'm going to go to North Dakota. Then I'm going to go to, you know. He campaigns. His whole presidency has been a campaign. It's all been about popularity. He thinks that if he talks about green, listen to me, follow me on this logic. And I'm telling you, folks, I am right. I am right. He thinks if he talks about green energy enough, that the speculators will raise the price of oil so much, if he puts enough regulations on the gas companies and oil companies to create a cleaner fuel for the upcoming summer driving season, which he has done, which is one of the reasons the refineries have shut down some of their plants, because they need to revamp their systems to make a cleaner fuel. President Obama thinks that if he makes gas prices go so high that people will say, oh my, I guess we should look towards green energy because prices are so high. That's what the president wants. Because if he cared about, if he did not care so much about his popularity, and he actually cared about you and me, the American wage earner, the middle class American, the American that pays their taxes, that everybody lives off the backs of a middle class American, the food stamper, the government assistance person lives off the back of the middle class. And the middle class is who gets hurt the most when they go to the gas pump. So if he really cared about the middle class, he would come out and say, doesn't even have to mean, I'm going to start thinking about drilling in this country. He doesn't have to do it. If he just says, I'm going to think about it, speculators will go crazy. Oh my God, let's lower the price of a barrel of oil. We don't want any drilling going on in the U.S. Oh no, we don't. We don't want America to be oil independent. No, we don't want them to be energy independent. Let's lower the price of oil so that they won't start drilling. And that's how to cure the high gas prices. But he won't do that because he does not care about me or you. It's either that or he's just plain stupid. Yeah, I said it. He's just plain stupid. How could you say that about the president, Tom? Oh my God, you're so disrespectful. What are you talking about? I'm disrespectful. He's disrespectful to me. He comes out on a podium and he calls me ordinary. The ordinary American. The average American. People, come on, let's think about it. Do you really think you're average? No. Do you really think you're just ordinary? No. And if you do, do not think that way anymore. Because you are not average. You are above average. You are extraordinary or extraordinary, however you want to word it. Come out and disrespect me and call me ordinary. Let me tell you something. Tom Shields is not ordinary. And people are like, yeah, no kidding. No kidding. Who said that? Really, come on, let's talk about it. Leading to more people needing state aid, needing welfare. That's what's happening. All federal and state employees should have a 5 or 10% cut. You're darn right. You know? We just have to create more jobs. We have no health insurance. We have no dental insurance. And if you want health insurance, what a Oh, can we just talk about this for a minute? Do you remember how stupid he was when he was campaigning for this health care at Obamacare? Remember how stupid he was? And he was so, like, he was so convinced. You can keep your I've told you. This is President Obama talking. I've told you. You can keep the doctor you have. You can keep the insurance plan that you have right now. There's just going to be a government insurance that you can lean towards if you want, but you can keep your current insurance. Remember he said that? You gotta remember him saying that. And I even back then I said, are you that stupid? Are you that stupid? Thinking that what you're doing is going to hurt the private insurance company so much that they're going to have no other choice to skyrocket their prices so that the average American that wanted to keep their health insurance program can no longer afford it. They can no longer afford it. That's what's happening. President Obama says, yes, you can keep your current health insurance program. But he forgot to mention if you could freaking afford it. Back when he said it, you could afford it. But there's another thing he came out and said. Government health care is going to be the way we're going to... Now, no one can afford health insurance anymore. Connecticut had a big place, North Haven, Connecticut. Big corporate building. Biggest... It was the Anthem Blue Cross Blue Shield building. For the last 30 years, it was there. Affordable health care for the individual. That's what they had. If you were a small business owner or self-employed, you could get your own health insurance and you could afford it. Well, because of what President Obama did, nobody can afford that small business plan anymore. If you're self-employed, you could no longer afford to pay for it because of President Obama's words and his program. Now, I couldn't believe my eyes. The big corporate building, they closed. They closed the building. Unemployed people. They could no longer afford to keep their doors open because President Obama and his regulations made the insurance companies have to raise their rates because more and more people were dropping out of the pool. Do you understand me? More and more people could not afford their health insurance, so they were dropping their health insurance, which was causing the insurance companies to raise their rates to bring in more revenue to the point where so many people were dropping out because they couldn't afford it anymore. They had to close the building. It's all because President Obama started this Obamacare and the regulations he put in. And now it's going to cost us more money. Oh my God. Oh my God, how stupid could he have been? Oh my God. I am scared to what's happening in this country. If a Republican doesn't get into the White House soon, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I am scared for my people in my family. I am scared for young people in my family. I don't know what's going on with the American. Oh, but Tom, President Obama is popular. He's so popular. Oh my God. We have hunger, we have homelessness, we have people who are robbing and stealing and killing. We have so much disarray in this country. But President Obama is going to go play golf with a man who cheated on his wife with prostitutes, and not just one, with many prostitutes. Very good-looking prostitutes, very sexy No. I'm getting off the topic. Do you understand what I'm saying? What kind of family value? What kind of what is he creating here? Oh my God. Do you follow me, folks? How can anybody disagree with what I'm saying? I might not be politically correct as to how I present my frustrations, but I'm sure you understand them. I am a good communicator. I can relay a message. I'm sure that you understand where I'm coming from, and you probably agree with everything I'm saying. Tom, he goes around it an odd way, but he's making some damn sense. At least Bill Clinton did things that I believe Bill Clinton cared about the country. Yeah, what did he do? Had some kind of sexual thing going on in the White House, you know. Politicians are just so screwed up, man. Oh, God. What are we going to do? You got a guy, the Speaker of the House, the head of Congress, who cries like a baby, goes to a tanning bed. Guy's freaking retard. I don't like that word. The guy has mental issues. You know? John Boehner, take a break, all right? Mature your mind a little or something. Go, you know. You know, you got President Obama playing golf with a home wrecker, with someone who cheated on his wife, with prostitutes. I mean, come on. And then the media, oh, President Obama, how was it playing golf with Tiger Woods? The media doesn't even care about what kind of crazy, how this just looked horrible. There can never be 100% working people. It can never happen. Government black holes, welfare, hunger, homeless, stupidity will never be stopped. And the list goes beyond that. You're right. Minnesota, I just saw that comment. What are we going to do, people? Really, what are we going to do? You know? Gas prices 50 cents a gallon, you know? It's going to, what is it? What do you think? This summer is going to be a break? If President Obama comes out and says one thing about drilling in the U.S., you watch those prices come down. But he won't. He has an agenda. He wants gas prices to go right through the roof so that he can convince people he was right about leaning and experimenting with green energy. That's why. There's a lot of dinosaurs out there, you know? Oil's gonna be around for a long time. All we gotta do is create jobs, man. Come on. You create jobs, you fix the housing crisis, you fix everything in this country. Pretty much it. If people have a comfortable place to live, they're gonna be more excited to be an American. They're gonna go out looking for any kind of job they can get. But Tom, then you know they should make $9 an hour if they're gonna go out and get any job. But then those jobs aren't gonna be available. Oh my God. Will that Democrat voice of mine just go away, please? Just go away. And I could swear that he said he would never raise taxes on the middle class. And he did. And he's still popular. No one's blaming him for anything. People are making the average age, a wage earner, is making about $40, $50 less a week. Not a month, a week. And no one's saying anything about it. I don't hear anyone talking about it but me. No one's in a rage about it. I even listen to Glenn Beck. I watch Fox News. No one's talking about it. No one's talking about gas, the rising gas prices. I saw something on the news, it was a 30-second bit. Gas prices are going up. Wow, how do you feel about that? What are you gonna do to conserve energy? Well, President Obama, what are we gonna do? And President Obama, he'll come to the podium and this is what he'll say. Well, I can't do his voice, but I'm being President Obama. Well, people, check the tire pressure in your car. Make sure that your tires are properly inflated and make sure you drive the speed limit and you'll conserve gas and it won't hurt your pocketbook that much. Really? Are you freaking kidding me? Are you freaking serious? That's what he has said in the past. That's what he's going to say in the future. He will be saying that again, I promise you. Instead of saying, why doesn't someone come up and say, hey, why don't you just talk about drilling in the U.S.? And then when the speculators and all the investors hear that, they'll lower gas prices. President? Why doesn't somebody say that? And maybe he'll think, but he won't think like that. Because he wants to convince people that green energy is the way of the future, and the only way for him to do that is for him to make sure that gas prices reach $5 a gallon this summer. Oh, I know you guys hate this part. Where is my, did I run this PSA yet? because I'm all red in the face, like I'm burning up here. I get really passionate, folks. You might think, oh, Tommy. I do. I get passionate. And I love people that come in and watch. I love people that watch the show and don't leave. Don't leave the room. Don't leave the program. It's live. You never know what's going to happen. You never know what I'm going to talk about. Why is it always political, Tom? Shut up! Yeah, I'm only kidding. No, my little voice, those are the Democrats talking to me. Those are people from the left that are criticizing the show. That's who that little voice is. I should have a little caption up over here. Little voice is coming from the left. That's what I need to do. I need to put a little caption up there that tells that. Oh, Tom, you know, your show is a little harsh. Then don't watch it. If you can't handle the truth about what's going on in the government, well, what makes you the authority, Tom? What makes you an authority on what's right and wrong in this country? Maybe almost 26 years of being a business owner. Maybe almost 26 years of owning about four different businesses and dealing with payroll, dealing with employees, dealing with paying unemployment insurance, dealing with paying taxes to the government, dealing with paying state insurance, state taxes, unemployment insurance. Maybe that makes me a little. What have you done, President Obama, to gain your experience? I've just listed my resume of why I have the authority to complain. What, President Obama, is your resume to run this country? What business experience do you have, President Obama? Well, have you even had a paper route? Have you even managed so much as a Dairy Queen?
Well, no, I've never had a paper route, and I've never had to deal with payroll, and I've never had to deal with paying taxes. I've never had to deal with unemployment insurance or paying the government money for... I never had to deal with hiring employees or firing employees. I never had to deal...
Then what makes you an authority on what's going to make this economic turnaround in this country? What makes you the authority about healthcare, what's right and what's wrong within the healthcare? What makes you an authority on running this country if you've never even managed so much as a Dairy Queen? Come on, never even had a paper route. At least when I was 16 years, 15 years old, I had a paper route. I had to collect money. I had to figure out what money is mine and what money I have to pay to the big paper company, what was left over. I had to figure out a strategy of how I'm gonna make at freaking 14, 15 years old. This guy is, I don't even know how old he is. What, 50 yet? Is he 50? He hasn't even had a paper route or managed even so much as a Dairy Queen, never had to deal with a payroll or figuring out how to handle new employees, figuring out an expense sheet, a profit and loss statement, never. But he's running the country. And what he says is right. Oh, ho, 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 ho. Yeah. And when I saw this poor woman who looked like she wanted to be home with her son, but she had to deliver pizzas to make extra money. Does Joe Biden and President Obama, do they see this? Do they actually know what's going on? Do they actually know about the homeless problem? Do they actually know about the poverty in this country? Do they actually realize what's going on? They just need to create a job. Just create it. How do they create jobs, Tom? Really? That'll be next week's show. I could tell you how to create a job. You lowered my tax burden so that I could take on another employee. You do not raise the minimum wage so I can afford to pay an employee. Hello? Do you think that if you asked the president, what do you think he would say? He would say this: we need to raise taxes on people
So the government takes in more money so we can create shovel-ready jobs.
That's what he would say. It's never going to happen. This does not happen. I'm not a construction worker. I don't even know a construction worker. How is that going to help? How is it going to help that poor woman who's delivering pizza if they create a shovel-ready job? You think she's going to take a shovel? You think she can handle a shovel-ready job? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. It's so scary. This government is so stupid. They're so stupid. Oh, my God. If we don't, I'm telling you, folks, if we don't get a Republican in the White House soon, this country, I'm just scared. I'm scared. I don't ask nobody for nothing. I'll go out, I'll make my own money. I don't ask nobody for nothing. I don't get government assistance. I don't get welfare. I don't even get health. I pay freaking like $210 a month. I have a freaking $6,000 deductible on my health insurance. Never used to be that way, but ever since Obamacare came into play, I could no longer barely afford my health insurance because of this president. So now maybe you understand why I'm so upset and why I come on here for 60 minutes. Can we go out on a lighter note now? Because I'm getting all red in the face. I've got like blotches of redness. Oh, God. Let's see if I wrote down anything fun to talk about. Can we create a job? Gas prices, taxes on the middle class. Invest in roads and bridges. Marco Rubio. You know, people, and one other thing. Yeah, I know, Mr. N. I really do. I have to, like, chill out for a second because I could feel the pressure. Do you know, folks, I used to go freaking so nuts on this show. I used to whip. Remember when I used to whip my head back and forth like this? Do you know? Oh, wow, I get dizzy easy now. I actually tore the retina in my eye from doing that. I had to have a freaking operation on my eyeball. They had to take my eyeball and put me to, like, in the twilight. I didn't actually go to sleep at twilight. They open up your eye, they take your eyeball and pop it out of its socket. They freaking cut around the equator of the eye. They put this thing called a scurl buckle around your eye to squeeze your eyeball. Then they take the thin skin of your eyeball, sew it back together, tighten the buckle so it squeezes your eye a little bit, and then boop, they pop the eyeball back in your head. And then you wake up. I have a freaking buckle on my eye because I was so passionate about this show that I used to go out of my freaking mind. So if that's not sacrifice, Tom's got a buckle on his eye. What kind of buckle does he have? Is it a belt buckle? Is it a Harley Davidson figurine? What kind of, is it a cowboy belt buckle? Stupid. No, an eye stroke. It was actually the inner wall, the retina of your eye is like, the way I was explaining, it's like wallpaper. You know when you put wallpaper on, you don't want to have a bubble. You want it to be nice and smooth. That's the inner part of your eye. Very nice and smooth, all put together like wallpaper. But as soon as you do something and the wallpaper bubbles, the wallpaper comes out just a little. You can't see. I was blind. I couldn't see. It was like someone took a lampshade, pulled it down. Half of my eye was black. The other part I could see. It freaked me the frig out. Freaked me out. I was freaking out. Yeah, Minnesota. Yeah, it wasn't fun. But now it has healed the way it should heal. You know, folks, let me just tell you real quick, and then I'm going to go into other things. There's so many people with major other problems. This is like a nothing. But after they put the eyeball back in, they took gas, like a helium gas, and they they injected it into my eyeball so that I had a bubble of gas. And I had to hold my head down and look at the ground for 7 days. Because that gas bubble had to rise to try to push the retina back in its place. It's amazing how they do it. Like the wallpaper, it was to push the wallpaper back into place and that little bubble. So when I looked straight ahead, I saw the bubble in my freaking eyeball. It was the freakiest thing. But I had to keep my head down for a week. I was out of my mind. I was crazy. So now I don't whip my head around anymore. And I'm good. Oh, you are Tiny Tammy? I don't know. Well, folks, I hope you enjoyed the program tonight. I hope you understand why I vent. I vent for everybody watching. I vent for everybody that likes the show, that is fed up with government. I vent for everybody. Mr. N, thank you very much. And Mr. N, just so you know, Walker, Matt, Tiny Tammy, everybody, see if you could put it on your calendar, put it in your iPhone to tune in this coming Tuesday. I'm not 100% sure, but if you see the countdown starting at 8:30, you tune into the show. If I'm doing the countdown, me and Stan will be doing a show. Don't quote me on that, but he called me up. He said, Tom, I want to start doing the show with you again, but I'm only available Tuesday nights. So I just have to get on the horn. And if I get him here, which I think he will come, we will have a blast. It'll probably be a 2-hour show. I might even start it early. All right, guys. Well, thanks so much for watching. Where was Cheryl tonight? I don't know what happened to Cheryl. I hope everything's okay. I'll have to give her a text or something. I know it was her birthday on the 17th. I hope she had a fun birthday. Well, folks, thanks for hanging in there. Thanks for being a fan. Spread the word, will you? So that we can get a bunch more people watching on this new network. I miss the thousands and thousands on the other network. Brantford, East Haven, North Haven. What did I forget? Brantford, East Haven, North Haven. Wallingford, Madison, Guilford. Thanks so much for checking in and hanging in there. Folks, Mr. Ed, everybody, you guys know I love you. Take care, I gotta run because I can't handle any editing. Oh my God, I gotta go.